self financing stream, the dynamic energy department of English, all the vibrant faculty members of our college. They are today's young team, the organizing team, the second PG English members, students, and the enthusiastic students, all the participants, and all the other invitees. Very pleasant good afternoon to all. So I feel very happy to join in this program. The department, English Department Association, English Association inauguration, and also the webinar on literature beyond boundaries. The topic itself giving me a new kind of energy. That's choosing this topic, which I really appreciate. It's wonderful. And at the outset, I extend my warm welcome to our chief guest. I really feel very happy to note that she was a faculty member of your own department, and more than that, she was in the department did her studies at the UG and PG here, I believe, and also had that she stood first. She scored the highest mark and ranked the university examinations, and was such a meritorious student. And also she was working here as a faculty in our college and did a good job. And she is also planning to go for higher studies and higher studies and for further job, I believe. And at this context, I extend my warm, my best wishes for her higher studies and other achievements in her life. And English is my pet subject in the sense that the English is the language which is most widely spoken. If you look at the languages spoken throughout the world, English is the, I think it is the third, the most widely spoken. And also, to my knowledge, I understand that this English is the language widely learned as a second language. So we also offer as a second language to our students because it is one of the vibrant medium and only through which the Indian people are communicating. So since there is a need, every colleges is offering this English as a second language apart from their native language. You can understand about how much importance this English language has got. And also that the English is the official language, I believe, which more than 60 countries are having this as official language. So in that extent, we can know that the importance of the English. And without knowing English, of course, getting a job these days is much difficult. And also that if you could converse in English, if you have a good communication and writing skills, and probably you will get better job. Your career will be much higher than the one who doesn't have a good knowledge in the English language. And of course, like if you or the you know the English is in a better way, probably you'll be get placed in various levels. The one which is this is much having a good scope is that the tourism sector and also the event management related. The event management related professions is one of the upcoming career option, and also the tourism industries where if you have a good language skill, English language skill, you can do wonders. So such that extent, English having its own good scope. And also when you, I had a habit of reading the books, English books, In Chennai, there is a separate library meant for the English reading, related books. All the other important books, including all the different novels and the different social literature-related books, are available. The one which I, which the book which I loved is that the Somerset Maugham, and has written some books on Three Musketeers, I believe, and that's really is our knowledge-gaining book, which also bringing kind of awareness on the culture of the various societies. And good reading, it really makes us to feel relaxed and getting kind of energy. And this is going beyond our heart, this English language, and we should really love to read and make use of the language for a better living. I am very confident that today's webinar is a topic like in Beyond Boundaries, and Madam will be able to give you significant points and where this will be and what are the scope and other related interventions. With this, I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to proceed over this function. I really feel ha very happy that when the madam, another department came and told me that the program is being hosted, being organized, and all this event is being managed by the students themselves. It's a really good beginning. I wish the each and every one of the members of the English department to showcase their talent and be students student, and of course make use of this for your productivity. Thank you all for giving this opportunity. Over to the admin, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for your kind and motivational speech, sir. Sir, due to some technical issue, there is a change in agenda. Our student, Ms. Porpudi Chitra,
Beyond Boundaries, organized by Department of English, the Venkataswamy Naidu College. We are proud to organize this event, and it's my pleasure to greet delightfully our respected chief guest, Mrs. W.M. Madhubalashree, MA, especially an alumna and former assistant professor, Department of English, the Venkataswamy Naidu College, Kolkata. We welcome you, ma'am. It's my honor to welcome our reverend secretary, respected principal, and energetic director of our college, who have supporting us like pillars. We welcome you, sirs and ma'am. Next, I feel we're happy to welcome our head and staff members of our department. We welcome you, sirs and ma'am. Last but not the least, I would like to welcome the students of our department and friends of this event. Once again, I welcome you all. Again, a hearty welcome to every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Porkudi Chitra. Now, I am grateful to welcome our respected director, Director Sir Dr. Venkatachalapathy, to share the felicitation address.
Thank you, ma'am. Respected Secretary of our college, Dr. P. Mahendra, the Chief Guest of today's function, W.M. Madhubalashree, the HOD of English Department, Kameshwari Madam, staff members, students, and organizers, student organizers. Thank you one and all for having given me the opportunity to deliver the felicitation address. First of all, I would like to straight away appreciate the efforts taken by the English Department for inaugurating the association function. And they have already chosen a very nice topic, the literature beyond boundaries. And they have chosen the right resource person for the same, Madhubalashree. And he was working with us before 3 years, and he contributed a lot for the development of the department. I am really happy to see that she is coming back to the college to deliver a seminar on literature beyond boundaries. And literature has no boundaries, no physical or mental boundaries. And whatever be the work in a particular language is actually translated into many languages, and our Thirukkural is one of the best example, and it has been translated into many languages, and it is widely accepted one across the world. Just like that, we adopted the literature from foreign countries, Western countries, and this is the only way by which we can actually come very close to each other. The literature really reflects the way of life at that particular point of time, and we can see the similarities of contemporaries at that time. We can simply compare the work of Kelly's and Shelley's and Bharatiyar. They are contemporaries, and if you are just to go through the work of them, certainly you may be able to find out there are certain similarities. So language is actually no problem. The thinking is almost the same. The wise man think alike, they say that. It is also happening in the literature field also. And I hope that Madhubala Sri will be giving you a lot of ideas about, so what are all the works that have been actually transcend the boundaries. And I hope this seminar will throw up a lot of knowledge for the students. And I hope the students will be making use of this nice seminar by way of interacting with the eminent resource person. And also thank this opportunity for our secretary sir and the department for having given me an opportunity to deliver the police station address. Thank you, Ananda.
Thank you, sir, for encouraging the spirit of all the staff and members, students. Thank you for your thoughtful words.
Thank you.
I would like to call upon Ms. Gayatri from 2nd MA English to introduce the chief person.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am profoundly delighted to take opportunity to introduce our chief guest, Mrs. W.M. Madhubala Sri. She did her bachelor degree in English literature in G. Venkateswamy Naidu College, Koyampattu. She received fourth rank in bachelor degree from Manonmaliam Sundaranath University. She did her bachelor education in PSR College of Education in Sivavasi. She did her master degree in English literature in C.S. Ramaswamy Naidu Memorial College, Sattur. She did master of education in Sri Veeraswamy Satya College of Education. She also did her bachelor degree in Hindi. She worked as an assistant professor of English in G. Venkateswamy Naidu College, Koyampattu. And also she worked as a teacher in RC Higher Secondary School, Koyampattu. She is such a talented person who knows smart board knowledge. She also well knowledge in Tamil, English, and Hindi. She has a strong ability to incorporate various concepts into producing lessons, and also she has a strong work ethic. Our guest also did her professional project in Paulo Coelho's The Alchemist and engaging oral English to rural students at tertiary level. She presented a paper on the title The Importance of Listening and Speaking in International Level Seminar and newspaper in English on Identity Crisis on Ladies Who in National Level Seminar. We are really fortunate to have such a renowned person amongst us. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Gayatri. It is my pleasure to welcome our guest, W.M. Madhubala Sri, M.A. M.Ed. Alumina and former assistant professor, Department of English, G. Venkateswamy Naidu College, to address the gathering.
Thank you. Thank you, one and all. And a very good afternoon. At first, I thank Secretary Sir for motivating with his words. Thank you, sir. And I thank our HOD ma'am for giving this platform for me. And I especially thank our director, sir, one of the kind person I ever seen. Thank you, sir. And I also thank my staff members, sir and ma'am, who mold me. And thanks for the young vibrance of today's English department, MA students, for organizing this meeting. And thank you. And it is really an honor and thrill to be here. Yes, I remember when I was joining at first, I feel panic and everything around me is new. But after that, I can feel that I'm in the right place and I rightly chose the course. It's all started in the year 2011. and my life changed on that day. Yes, rolled on. Now here I am. So after the heavy food, we are all gathered here. And maybe some of you feel sleepy or some of you feel drowsy. Might some of you get interested? What are the things are gonna to be shared? So let us busy as a popcorn in the skillet. Okay, don't be as flat as a dosa. Now I'm going to share a PPT. I hope you are all are can see my picture. Yes, the topic literature beyond boundaries. And the overview of my presentation, I just divided our topic into three parts. The first part, we are going to see about what is boundary. And then the second part, we have to discuss about the types of boundary. What are the boundaries? And in third part, how to break boundaries and success in your life. Okay, so these are the parts we are going to discuss in this webinar. So let's start. So when you feel, what is the boundaries? Initially, what we have know is what is boundaries. When we think boundaries, we think about a frame or a division or a rule, or we make a regulations or restrictions. Now you can see a picture. Can you text me? Every picture they have connected with the mobile phones, but they are disconnected in life. Just think, whenever we are go everywhere, we just hold our mobile phones with our hands, but we have failed to see, we have failed to connect ourselves with life. Just to keep it, keep this picture in your mind. I will tell about it later. And we are enter into the part one about what is boundary. A boundary is a real or imaginary line that separates two things. Robin Sharma also says that the fears that we don't face becomes our boundaries. We are not ready to face the problems in our life. We just create a fear within ourselves. So that is called an imaginary line of boundary. We create a certain fears in ourselves. We create certain stress in ourselves. So this is called an imaginary line of boundary. And we create rules, limitations, regulations, and restrictions that we set within ourselves. It is a real boundary. When almost we are in the stage of shrinking ourselves inside our home as the pandemic rushes out of the streets. Actually, we are almost stayed in home for 2 years, but all we want is privacy. As we social distancing ourselves from the society, we also distance the collaboration between our mind and our body. We put certain limitations to our friends, relationship, parents. So we are stuck in the maze. Don't you feel you are stuck in a matchbox? So life is all about coming out of the matchbox. When you are ready to come out of that box, come out of your house, come out of your comfort zone, and force our life out of the crisis, and you have to burn the problem and give light for the world. Matchsticks are not valuable if you store into the box. Okay, the purpose of life should be happened. You are anointed. It is your call. You have to lead your life. Okay. And how do we create our boundaries? As a teenager, we are too old to do what the kids do. We are too young what adults do. Here, I want to give an example. We think, no, if I play with the toy or with the teddy, the people may think I am a kid. No, I am too old. I can't do what the kids do. And being a young person, you can't do what the experts do. That time also you says that, no, that are the things which is only done by the adults, not by me, because I am too young. So these are the boundaries we create within ourselves. So here I mention a young boy who's 18 years old named Shah Rukh. He invented Kalamsat. It's known by Abdul Kalam satellite. It is the one of the lightest and smallest satellite for NASA. He is a young person. He is not an adult. So in our life, we create our own boundaries. Okay. Next, we will talk about types of the boundaries. Nearly there are so many types of boundaries, but here I want to mention a major boundaries for you. At first, friendship boundaries. Okay. So Francis Bacon, he is a great and famous essayist of friendship. He points out a noble fruits of friendship. At first, he noticed the peace in the affections. Here I show a picture which depicts the Mahabharata. At last, the Krishna will help Arjuna. So everywhere you have to find a peace in your friendship. And a second noble fruit is support for the judgment. You have to support your friend, but when a friend does a mistake, commits a mistake, you have to mention it. Sarah, you said it correctly. Abhin said it. Vishyam karayam. You have to support the judgment. Friends help one to make better judgments in tough situations. If you correct the friend's mistake, yes, he can come forward to help you. And moreover, the third noble fruit of friendship is aid and bearing a part in all actions and occasions. So, if you are going for a birthday party, you will enjoy with your friend. But if it is, this friendship is a good one, means you have to support your friend while he or she is in a sad stage. That is an important role every friend, every good friend done in that stages. So I want to give an literary example as friendship as a boundary. Here, Wordsworth and Coleridge, they are the two most famous poets in literature. And they become friends. And their friendship is rooted in one marvelous year between 1797 to 98. They wanted together in wild poesy. So they started to lyrical ballads, which is published in 1798. In that ballads, Wordsworth started to reject the important work of Coleridge, named The Rime of the Ancient Mariner. So in that poem, we come across some albatross. Yes. Wordsworth just neglect this poem in the lyrical ballads, but he was, but Coleridge was looking a father figure. He has a fond of Wordsworth. Coleridge loves Wordsworth. He just sees his father in Wordsworth, but Wordsworth betrayed him. Already, Wordsworth was feeding on two other geniuses, known as his sister Dorothy Wordsworth and Coleridge. But Wordsworth betrayed Coleridge, even though he is a great friendship with him. And moreover, how Wordsworth manipulatively act upon Coleridge? Wordsworth's jealousy ambition fed his ego, while Coleridge's addiction resulted from his heavy consumption of opium. He started to take opium and he believed that he needed to inspire his creativity. A man, Richard Holmes, who is a biographer of Coleridge, he just shows a number of issues between these two people, Wordsworth and Coleridge. And he says that Wordsworth was a bully. Here, what is the word meant by bully? Bully is a person who uses his strength to hurt the one who are weaker. So Wordsworth considered Coleridge as a weaker man. He does not show the true friendship. Instead, Wordsworth decided to profit from his friend's addiction. So he added more and more excessive consumption of opium. It leads Coleridge to death. And moreover, I want to say that crowd is not a company. If you are in a crowd, it is not about friendship. Here I would give an example. This is the true friendship. And I give you another example. In Harry Potter, the three friends, you know, already about that. Harry Potter, Ron Weasley, and Hermione Granger. Yes. About their friendship. We are only as strong as we are united, as weak as we divided. So they feel strong when they are united. They are not the crowd. Even a single person make a good friendship. But you can to believe it. You can faith in that friendship. You have to help one another. You have to elevate one another. Okay, so coming to the next boundary, relationship as boundary. Yes, here also, I wanted to give an example from literature. Julius Caesar, he is the greatest general and politician of the end of the Roman Republic, as all we know that. And Cleopatra loves Julius Caesar and his brother Antonio. Expand of her land. That is not the real relationship. Cleopatra needs the power of Caesar's armies. For that sake only, Cleopatra loves Julius Caesar. So here, where is a good relationship? And also, I show the picture from Guna film. So in that film, Guna and Abhirami loves one another. Yes, of course, their love is true. Their relationship is true. But it leads his life in struggle. It spoils his life, you know. So where is the relationship here? And Bacon says that it is an important line. Nuptial love made the mankind friendly love. Perfect, but wanton love corrupt and embarrassed. He means that nuptial love means a marriage love. It make a mankind, and friendly love it perfect you, but wanton love it will corrupt you. Okay, but here in Romeo Juliet, so everyone says that Romeo Juliet is an epic for love, but Romeo, at first, he does, when he entered into the Capulet's party, he wanted to see a Rosalind, not a Juliet. So that may be also a boundaries. That may also it is not a true love. So here I want to tell that when you enter into the college, this is your first step. For the first years, I talk about, and for the seniors also, it is your career, it is your life. If a person, if a man, if a boy or if a girl gives you a pen, gives you a water, it doesn't mean a love. Because a true love must flourishes the life. It should be meaningful to your life. Okay. And we are move on to the physical boundaries. So far we see two boundaries, which are friendship boundaries and relationship boundaries. Now we are going to see about physical boundaries. Okay. A person who is a poet and a satirist during Augustan period is Alexander Pope. He is a hunchback man. For example, we all see the movie Peralagan. Okay, in Peralagan movie, Surya has a hunchback. You know that? Yes. Likewise, Alexander Pope has a hunchback when he was hit by some bull. Okay, that's not a matter. But he is affected by some disability. So, Joshua Reynolds described Alexander Pope's appearance. He was 4 feet 6 inches high, very compact and deformed. Alexander Pope, though he was a great man, he was satirized. He was described as these words. So he also suffered from Port's disease. Port's disease is nothing but tuberculosis of the spine. Okay, so he died at the age of 56 of what apparently was congestive failure. And he wrote in his book, The Club of Little Men, which is published in 1713, he describes the ridiculous rituals of a group of short men. He just describing about a short man and providing a self-mocking and humorous insight. And also, his famous work, his epic, mock epic, named The Dunciad, which is published in 1713, he uses the poem to attack who criticize his work, such as Colley Cibber, says, less human genius than God gives an ape. Yes, he compares Pope to a monkey, an ape. So here we have to know that even though the Pope was criticized by the very men, he published these greatest epics in literature. So he created so many epic works with his disability. So in a Dunciad, he just gave a picture which has a monkey as a hunchback. And also he delivered an essay on criticism. These works are greater in literature. And we move on to Johnson, Samuel Johnson, who had a poor eyesight and he also affected by the Tourette syndrome. Tourette syndrome means it is a disease in the nervous. Many of you see that some person nodded their head while speaking. They have a nervous disease. So likewise, Johnson has a disease in his nervous. His friend Boswell says that he had a Tourette syndrome and obsessive compulsive disorder. But with this disorder, with this physical disability, he can create a preface to Shakespeare, the greatest work, and he write the best and the first dictionary in the world. Without him, we can't even search the meanings. Yes. And moreover, Milton, yes, Milton is one of a greatest man who is known for his On His Blindness work. He lost his sight in the age of 45. He doesn't bother about any technology. He uses his daughters. When his daughter read to him, and he dictated his writing to the transcriber. So that's why the work On His Blindness is delivered, is published. Okay, so these are the men who can do some famous work even though they are in a physical problems. So here I wanted to tell that even though we have some physical problem or mental problem or emotional, you can do so many things. So don't bother about your physical disabilities. Even though I mentioned Stephen Hawking, he also suffered from a motor neuron disease. He's paralyzed throughout his life, but he was awarded a Presidential Medal of Freedom by Obama. So it is not only the thing that you are you have some physical abilities, no, or mental abilities or emotional abilities, no, that is not a problem. You can create as you like. And how to overcome physical boundaries? Yes, here I must mention about a self-love. In our point of view, self-love is about the structure we maintain. No, it is not about the structure we maintain. It is all about how you find happiness in everything. How you find a love. How you find enjoyment. How you find a good companionship and a balance in your life. So that is the best self-love. It is all about how you treat yourself. How you work with more love. So thus you have overcome with physical boundaries. Okay, I think I don't bore them to you. Next, we are going to the language boundaries. For first year students, I mentioned you are all know about the literature and you are going to study a literature, but you have a fear in you that how can I study English language? I am from Tamil medium. I can't do anything. I can't study an essay. I can't write in my own. No, you don't bother about it. A language border or language boundary is the line separating two languages. That is called a language as a boundary. So English language borrowed words from nearly 350 foreign languages, or with slight or without any modification. So through reading world literature and practicing linguistics, the second language speaker can break the boundaries. You can break the boundaries by studying the world literature, because you can read so many words. You can know about the words. When you limit yourself with the word you know, there you put limit for your knowledge. If you learn many languages, your world and vision heightens. For example, in this picture, I said hello, namaste, and banjo, hello. So these are all the words borrowed from the foreign languages. Okay, so don't bother about the languages which you are going to study. For example, I am here show about the loan words. Loan words is nothing but it's a borrowed words from the foreign languages, which I said before. For example, deja vu. We already known about the word in the movie Nanban. There, a character says about deja vu or jamayu. It is a word. It is a French word which means already seen. Ajama, you mean you know the person, but forget the face. So these are the word. This is not an English word, but they are borrowed the word from a French. And we say the word ayu. Yes, when you refer through the dictionary, these words are appear because it is borrowed from our Dravidian languages. And the moreover, the word the last word I mentioned here is milgitvani. What is a milgitvani? It is a milagu thanni, pepper water. It's a, you mean a rasam, you know that. So it is simple. They just borrowed the word from our language and make them theirs. Okay, and how you overcome language boundaries? You think that learning a second language is so hard one, I can't know, I can't learn that thing. But at first it feels like that, but it leads to wide knowledge around the world. You are happening to, you are going to learn so many words. You are going to learn so many words from other literature. So your knowledge to become a wide level. Here I mention an example from Epithalamion. It is the opening lines of the Epithalamion. So with these lines, you can understand how to overcome a language boundaries. You learn, sisters, which have oftentimes been to me aiding others to adorn. So the first line itself says, you learn, sisters. So in our English, namma enna nenappom? Oh, padichu sahodrigala. No, it is not like that. In Greek, you learn, sister, means a nine muses. A nine muses. The poet invites, invokes, praises these muses. So muses means angels. For the marriage, he invites these angels for the marriage. So you have to learn these words now, and you also know about that literature. So thus you have to overcome a language boundaries. Okay, understand? Okay. And also I want to say that Samuel Johnson, as already we see him, he has some disabilities. But in his preface to Shakespeare, which is published in 1765, it is one of the greatest book ever. And he states that Shakespeare is a tree in a forest, not a plant in a garden. Can you understand what I'm saying? Yes. Whenever in a forest, a tree just extended their branches and pine towers in the air, interspersed sometimes with weeds and brambles, and also it sometimes gives shelter. So in my I want to tell you that be a tree in a forest, not a plant in a garden. Your knowledge should be a wide. Okay, and now here I want give you an activity. Yes, I think you are all awake for my advice. Can you turn on your video? Not a audio. Can you turn on your video alone, second MA students alone? Hey, are you there or are you asleep? Yeah, thank you.
Hi, ma'am.
Hi. Thank you so much. And yes, I think you are all awake. Now I'm going to read a story. Okay. You have to, when I was said to write, you have to show your hands right side. Okay. When I'm said left, you showing a hand left side. Can you understand what I'm saying? Don't panic, okay? It's just a game. It's just activities to keep you awake. I think you are all just listen, okay, what are the things he has, she is talking, okay, I want to listen. It's nothing but, okay, shall we start, my dear students? Okay, I already seen you. When okay, wait, I will. Okay, I'm going to tell a story. Oh, where are the persons? There are no many persons seen in my video. I think you are all awake. Yeah, Devika, I can see you now.
Yes, ma'am.
So, I can do the exercise for you. Okay, when I am. Yes, when I said the word right, you have to show your hand it's right. When I said a word left, you show your hand to left. Okay, are you ready? Yes. Mrs. Wright's school class was just about finishing decorating. Mrs. Wright, her other daughter Susie Wright, and their cousin Sally Wright. No, I think you are all in a sleepy mode. Okay, so no problem. Thank you for your contribution. And now I move on to present my paper. It's not no worry at all. Okay, thank you. And move on to the next boundaries. Okay. The cultural boundaries. Okay. Here, I want to explain about the cultural boundaries. And Alan Langer, a man who says in her book named Mindfulness, when you perceive choice, you perceive motivation. You're motivated. So the deal is, for yourself, sit back and reflect. You have a mindful of choices in your hand. And you have to talk about success seeker rather than a failure avoider. Okay, it's all about how you talk, how you communicate yourself, how you communicate with others. Now I want to give you a gift. Nothing but a gift. It's a word. Okay, it's a C word. Community. Yes, it's a powerful word. A sense of connection with other people. It feel motivated and it felt the connection with other people. Now I want to recite a poem. It's called The Cookie Thief. It is written by Valerie Cox. Okay, so now as I recite the poem, there are only two characters which I already shown in that slide. There are only two characters, a man and a lady. So now put yourself in that situation. Okay, and be mindful, be careful, think about the situation and what you would do. Now I'm going to narrate. A woman who was waiting at an airport one night with several long hours before her flight, she hunted for a book in an airport shops, bought a bag of cookies and found a place to drop. She was engrossed in her book but happened to see that a man sitting beside her, as bold as he could be, grabbed a cookie or two from the bag in between, which she tried to ignore to avoid a scene. So she munched the cookies and watched the clock and read the books as the gusty cookie thief diminished her stock. She was getting more irritated as the minutes ticked by, thinking if I wasn't so nice, I would blacken his eye. With each cookie she took, he took one too. When only one was left, the last one was left, she wondered what he would do. With a smile on his face and a nervous laugh, he took the last one and broke it off. He offered her off as he ate the other She snatched it from him and thought, "Oh, brother, this guy has some nerve and he's also rude. Why he didn't even show any gratitude?" She had never known when she had been so cold and sighed with the relief when her flight was called. She gathered all her belongings and headed to the gate and refusing to look back at the thieving ingrate. She boarded the plane and sank in her seat. Then she shot her book, which is almost complete. As she reached in her bag, she gasped with surprise. There was her bag of cookies in front of her eyes. She's surprised. "If mine are here," she moaned in despair. "The others were his and tried to share, and he is the one who tried to share. Too late to apologize." She realized with grief that she was the rude one, the ingrate. She was the cookie thief. Yes. So with this poem, here I mention, where were you? Whose side were you? We are, whether you are independent or interdependent, just think. So my dear students, we are raised to be independent in this society. We are thinking that I don't need anybody in my life. I will do it on myself. But the truth, the reality is we need each other. We need a sense of community. That's why the community, the word is so much powerful. If your life is a storybook and you are an author, what story you are going to write? Think about it. You need a society and be the change. Okay. And coming to the next boundaries, psychological boundaries. And everyone says that brain is a complicated one and brain is a complex one. It can't think, it won't work. We can't understand what the brain thinks. No, it's nothing like that. And let me tell you the 4 points are about your mind. So these are the most important boundaries. Today you have to think, you have to analyze these 4 points, compare with yourself. Okay. Number one, your mind think and do what you want, what is your bigger interest. Now you are all here, you are sitting in front of your phone or a laptop, something, you are watching, you are listening to the webinar, but your mind wanted to see some web series or a movie. Your mind, if you think, if you talk, "This work is killing me, this is very irritating, I can't do this work." If you are telling like this, you are not telling to you, you are actually telling it to your mind that you don't want to do it. So it will encourage you to procrastinate, to bunk off. And it doesn't want to allow you to do, because your mind is so specific to the words which you use. And moreover, it is not about a resiliate. Resiliate means it is not about a positive thinking. It's actually you collaborating your mind. So look at your behavior. If you haven't got what you want, you are not communicating properly with your mind. உங்களுக்கு ஒண்ணு பண்ண பிடிக்கல அப்படின்னா நீ உன்னோட மைண்ட் கூட கரெக்டா கம்யூனிகேட் பண்ணலன்னு அர்த்தம். ஓகே, சோ தட் இஸ் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாயிண்ட். அண்ட் தி செகண்ட் பாயிண்ட் ஹியர் ஐ வாண்ட் டு மென்ஷன், யுவர் மைண்ட் இஸ் ஹார்ட் வயர் டு மூவ் யூ டுவோர்ட்ஸ் பெயின் டு பிளஷர். சோ this slide, the first point, I think, you know, I said, you know, that if you want to do something, edavadhu seiyanum aasapatta appadina, okay, your mind will follow you. So that's what Paulo Coelho says in his book Alchemist: when you want something, all the universe conspires in helping you to achieve it. Okay, so needa onnoda mind ku correct ana instruction kudukom. And the second one, your mind is hardwired to move you towards pain to pleasure. Yes. For example, if you're supposed to climb in a mountain, at first you feel the pain, whether it is a body pain or the mental pain, you must feel that pain. But whenever you touch the top of the mountain, in the peak of the mountain, you feel the pleasure, you feel the success. So here I mention about your education, your studies and your career. Whether it is the studies, whether it is in your career, at first it will give you pain. Oh my God, why I chose this course? Why I chose this career in my life? No, at last you reach the success. You feel the pleasure that you want. But if you failed to feel the pain at first, okay, you just postponed the things. You just neglect the important things. You just give the focus on only pleasure. At last, you must feel the pain. Only pain. In future, you must feel only pain. And moreover, the third point, here I mentioned, the way you feel about everything all the time is only down to two things. The picture that you make in your head and the words you say to yourself. Yes, here I give you a favorite example. Just close your eyes. Okay? Just close your eyes. Just imagine what I'm saying. Okay? Just imagine you are in a hungry state. Very hungry. You are don't even drink a drop of water. You are in hungry. So that time, a plate of talapakatti biryani serves in front of you with the long leg piece covered with masalas, and you have to take that leg piece near to your mouth, and you have to chew. Now open your eyes. What do you feel? Yes, your mouth is salivating. So this is the picture you want to create in your mind. For example, if you want to study in an abroad, in future, if you want to study in abroad, you just create an imagination. You think, yes, I am the student, enter into the Cambridge University. I am walking through the university and I am sitting in the bench of the Cambridge University. Yes, these are the images you must create within your mind. And you have to say yourself, yes, I will go. I will study there. So these are the points you have to feed to your mind. Okay. And move on to the fourth point. Your mind loves what familiar is. It is already programmed. Your mind is already programmed. It is keep going. What is familiar? Okay. If you want to success in your life, you must know about familiar, unfamiliar. Okay. This is a biryani for you. And familiar and unfamiliar. And unfamiliar to familiar. You must know the difference between these two. Familiar, unfamiliar means in that point, we do not respect, we do not believe in ourselves. We just procrastinate our mind. But in unfamiliar to familiar, it is the main thing you must do. You are working hard. You are going to working hard. You are decide to love your work. You have to say that I am good at what I'm doing. Yes, I am an expert at this. You must tell yourself, this is unfamiliar to familiar. Don't think of going back to fear or stress. we people just saying that fear if edavadhu or work unakku kudukranga edavadhu uni pesanum appadina no ma'am no sir I got a fear no this is not time to fear because your potential expands as you move towards to it you can't even know what your potential is if you start to dare you know your potential okay so told these four things to yourself and make that happen whenever you started to saying these four things your mind follow you don't want to follow your mind okay you have to control your mind and moreover step outside from your comfort zone we people just create a circle no I can't do anything this is my comfort zone I must sit in this place I don't want to be come out of this place no this is not this generation because this generation is a competitive world okay you have to come out from this comfort zone to lead the success okay and moreover when you ready to crossing the boundaries for your life you must stay out from the comfort zone and here are the some references gave and so far we just learn about types of boundaries and which will lead you to change your life I think so and moreover thank you for this opportunity thank you so much ma'am I feel very pleasure I got goosebumps when I am back to my college and thank you so much ma'am
thank you ma'am for your inspiring words it is my pleasure to invite Ms. Sweta from Second MA English to conclude the session
good afternoon one and all present here it gives me an immense pleasure to deliver the vote of thanks for this event to all dignitaries assembled here first of all I would like to thank our chief guest Mrs. W.M. Madhubala Sri who honored this function with her inspirational thoughts thank you ma'am and I would like to take this opportunity to express our sincere thanks to our honorable secretary Dr. P. Mahendran for joining us today thank you sir we are very grateful to our beloved principal Dr. N.R. Shanti Maheshwari for providing enormous support to us thank you ma'am we are extremely thankful to our dynamic director Dr. G. Venkatacharapati for his continuous assistance in organizing such a program thank you sir and I would like to thank our beloved HOD staff members students volunteers and last but not least our beloved audience for making this function as a great success once again I thank one and all present here thank you
Ms. Sweta